The Premier has admitted he'll rewrite Victoria's roadmap if Melbourne's stubborn numbers remain in the double digits. 15 new cases were reported today as violence and frustration boiled over on the streets of Elsternwick. Laura Turner reports.
Lockdown anger turning to violence.
Get out of it, man!
You're
a disgrace! Stop attacking!
Elsternwick residents clashing with members of the Jewish community, accusing them of flouting COVID restrictions.
You get out of my...
Get out of her face!
As a large group streamed out of a Das Israel school on Saturday night, residents filmed what appeared to have been a mass gathering.
I'm having exercise, madam.
What about you?
Victoria Police today confirming members attended but identified no breaches. This is Victoria's COVID case numbers refuse to budge.
It's that stubborn tail, those last few cases, one outbreak, two outbreaks.
The state's 15 new cases have pushed Melbourne's 14-day rolling average up from 9.3 to 9.9. That number needs to be 5 or below for us to take the next step. It's clear now we won't make that target, which means this Sunday's announcements will be limited.
We'll be broadly in that social space rather than economic easing, but we may be able to do more on that front in regional Victoria.
The frustration of Victorians reaching Canberra.
My message to Daniel Andrews is to get on with it, is to stop stringing people along and give them an opportunity to get about their daily normal lives in a COVID-safe way.
I don't think they'll be standing beside me having to explain why our hospital system is completely overrun. You won't see them for dust. So that's not leadership.
There were no new deaths recorded and our number of active infections has risen by 2 to 191. And alarmingly, there are 2 new mystery cases in the areas of Elwood Brighton Road and Newport Spotswood South Kingsville. 10 of today's 15 cases are linked to known outbreaks, including the family clusters in the southeast and north. The stubborn numbers forcing the Premier to admit for the first time the roadmap out might have to be rewritten.
It may be at a point where we have to call it and we have to say, look, this is as good as it's going to get.
And Laura is at Waverley Gardens. Laura, it's now on the list of high-risk locations.
It is, Peter. We are right in the middle of the Premier's electorate out here, and now Waverley Gardens is on the list of hotspots. DHHS says a COVID-positive person was out here in the dry cleaners inside the centre here on October 3rd between 10 a.m. and 2 p.m. And Altona has made the list of hotspots again. DHHS saying that someone was in the Altona North Aldi on October the 5th, and another case at the Fiesta Market there on the same day. So, of course, if you have symptoms, you've been in these locations on those dates, of course, go ahead and get tested, Pete.
Laura Turner reporting.